So it's just turned December, and you know what that means. That means putting up the Christmas tree, having fun with family, and this song. All I want for Christmas
is you.
Over the Christmas time, you hear the song everywhere. On the radio, when you go shopping, even in your Spotify playlist, you hear the song everywhere. So at the beginning of the song, she says, "I don't want a lot for Christmas." Why doesn't she want a lot for Christmas? She's obviously hiding something. And this, my friend, is where I am going to dig deeper in the rabbit hole. So what is she hiding, you might ask? Unfortunately, I can't tell you that because we don't know. But in the video, we can see some things that might hint to what we are looking for. So I'm going to show you a clip from the song to show you what she might be hiding. Stop. Right, ignore the fact that there's a Santa Claus and a chair in the middle of nowhere waiting for Mariah Carey. Look at that sack of presents, eh? That looks a bit suspicious, don't you think? There's something that she's hiding in that sack of presents. But I'll get back to that in a second. This will all make sense later. Wait, stop it right there. Go back. So here is a dog dressed up as a reindeer or an elf, or an elfin deer, whatever you'd like to be called. So here is basically dog labour. Santa Claus is promoting dog labour to you, ladies and gentlemen. I mean,
kill me.
He's obviously getting dogs and making them make the toys that you ask for and ride the sleigh for Santa Claus. Yeah, so they are promoting animal slavery on this. That is another conspiracy theory. Conspiracy theory solving. What are we talking about? Let's zoom into that sack over there. The moment that you've all been waiting for. Right, Mariah Carey is like a mermaid. She lures men in. What do you think this is called? All I Want for Christmas Is You. Right, so now let's look at the 2016 version that she made in 2016. Don't worry, this is all gonna make sense in just a few seconds. You. Nor Spazzy McGee here having a spaz attack. Look over here. You know where what's meant to be there? That's right, the sack. Why is the sack not here? Forget Santa Claus and the dog. Why isn't the sack? She's obviously hiding something in that sack. So let's look back at the sack. So there are different theories on explaining why the sack is there. One theory is that she's taking drugs and that's why Santa Claus and that chair is sitting there in the middle of nowhere. Another theory, she's very lonely and she's luring men in, like I said. But then I thought, that can't be the answer. Because she's engaged. She's engaged to, let's see who it is, let's see right here on the internet. She's engaged to James Packer. So then I looked online to see what Santa Claus originated from. He originated from Greek mythology and he used to place presents on people's doorsteps and help the gods out with their work, like Poseidon and Neptune. I think Neptune and Poseidon are the same thing, but still. So I looked more on the story and this is an extract on what happened to him over the years. Over the years, the legend spread, and in time, Roman Catholic Church canonized him as Saint Nicholas. The legend made its way throughout most of the European nations. Santa Claus is a variation of his Dutch name, Sinterklaas, and a few new twists were added over the years. Somewhere along the way, his white horse were traded in for a team of reindeer, and in the 20th century America, his hat was made a little bit more fashionable. But there is a little doubt that Santa Claus is St. Nicholas, Bishop of Maria. So after hearing this story of Greek mythology, I looked online and done some research on what is and who is the Bishop of Maria. So I've done some research on him, and I found this picture of him. Here it is right here. Can you see anything that you might recognise in this picture? No? Well, what if I zoom in? Exactly. The sack. Or I keep running into the same sack. And it could mean that she's trying to lure somebody in, but I just don't know now. Because if the sack goes all the way back there, I just don't know. Looking at this, two sacks, one in the picture of the Bishop of Maria, and one in the All I Want for Christmas Is You. I was looking at it for half an hour, just thinking what it could mean. Then I realised she could have went back in time, or she was somebody in that time. She took the Bishop of Maria's sack, because in the picture it shows that he's got three. And in All I Want for Christmas, there's only one. So this could mean that what's in the sack is riches, or something equivalent to that. Something that's worth a fortune. But the Saint of Maria, or the Bishop of Maria, didn't want them to have that, because we knew we would spend it on something that we didn't need. So she obviously stole it from that time, and then gave it to all the radio stations, Spotify, the shops, and they are not telling us. They are not telling us. So this means that hello, if you're listening to this, please go to Greece, go to Maria, and wait till the 6th of December and wait for Bishop of Maria. I got myself in some serious shit. I tampered with All I Want for Christmas Is You, and how the sacks were involved with his picture and in the music video. As soon as you see the Bishop, he will take you somewhere, and he will help you. I can't help you now anymore. It's all up to you. So if you made it this far into the video, thank you guys for watching. I made this video because I hear this song everywhere I go and thought it would be funny to make like a conspiracy theory video. This video took me quite long to edit, and I don't normally pray for likes or beg for likes. So please can you give this video about 5 likes. I think that's a reasonable goal for what I normally get. And please share this on your social media and all that, because I want this to get more attention. Because it did take me quite some time to edit. Anyway, nothing else to say. So see you guys in the next video. And hope you guys enjoyed it.